click to subscribe to the channel and then press the bell icon to get regular updates of videos, live sessions, and important seminars.
So the preparation of interview starts from the day you are born. Your birthplace, your city, your district, your subject you have chosen in 10th class, 12th class, your school, everything. Everything under the sun comes in interview. But the thing is, how to prepare for that and what you can do that, you know, you are not taken aback when someone asks a question in the board. So the main thing is focusing on your detailed application form and how to fill that form. There are many columns like hobbies, interests, leadership skills, positions of responsibilities you have hold in your college, your graduation time, and the subject you have taken. Like suppose you have done engineering. So for board members, it's not engineering. Like suppose you are a computer engineer. For them, it's engineering. They can ask anything under the sun of related to engineering. Like in the, suppose you are a mechanical engineer or suppose you are a civil engineer, they will ask artificial intelligence because they think that you are an engineer. You should be knowing about these things as well. And they can go deeper as well for suppose you are from arts background or commerce background. If you are from arts background, it totally depends on the mood of the panel where they want to go. So you have to be prepared for everything. So first of all, there is a disclaimer. This is a interview and it's very subjective. It can go any direction from anywhere, but it depends on you if you want to take it, like if you want to bring it back on the track or not. So ye hota ye hai ki 6-7 board hote hain, alag alag type ke board hote hain. तो आप किसी पर्टिकुलर बोर्ड के हिसाब से प्रिपेयर नहीं कर सकते. ये नहीं सोच सकते कि मेरे तो बस्सी सर आएंगे तो मैं तैयार रहूँगा स्ट्रेस इंटरव्यू के लिए, या फिर मेरे जोशी सर आएंगे तो मेरे तो मार्क्स कम ही आएंगे, या फिर जैसे सुजाता मेहता मैम आएंगी तो मेरा तो बहुत अच्छा जाएगा और मैं हंसते खेलते बाहर निकल जाऊँगा और मेरे 200 आ जाएंगे. तो ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. सारे बोर्ड्स इक्वली कॉम्पिटेंट है, इक्वली फेवरेबल हैं टुवर्ड्स कैंडिडेट्स. दे जस्ट वॉन्ट टू सेलेक्ट द राइट कैंडिडेट्स. मतलब ऐसा नहीं है कि बस ही सर आएंगे तो 120 दे देंगे, जाओ घर जाओ, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. वो भी 200 देते हैं. इफ़ यू ऑब्जर्व सबका मार्क्स, सबको ही अच्छे मार्क्स भी देता है, सबको ही बुरे मार्क्स भी देता है. भोसले सर 200 भी देते हैं, 140 भी देते हैं. मेरे इंटरव्यू में मुझे 206 मिले, मेरे नेक्स्ट वाले को 138 मिले. तो ऐसा जनरलाइजेशन जो बाहर मार्केट में या बाहर लोग बोलेंगे कि ये वाला बोर्ड बहुत फाइटर है और तुम इंटरव्यू में बैठे हो, अचानक से तुम्हें पता चलता है कि तुम्हारे जोशी सर हैं, अब तुम्हें वहाँ पे डर लगने लगेगा कि अब तो जोशी सर हैं, मेरे तो वैसे ही 120 आएंगे, मेरा तो होगा ही नहीं इस बार, मैं अगली बार के लिए प्रिपरेशन शुरू करता हूँ. तो ये सब जो प्री कॉन्सिप्ट नोशंस हैं, यू हैव टू थ्रो इट अवे. जस्ट थिंक इट्स अ इंटरव्यू और तुम उसके मास्टर हो. जब तुम लोगों के ट्रांसक्रिप्ट पढ़ते हो ना, व्हेन यू आर रीडिंग ट्रांसक्रिप्ट्स ऑफ अदर पीपल, व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट there is a particular circumstance, there is a situation in which those questions are being asked. So don't think that these questions are so tough, how will I answer these questions. Your interview will go on a totally different line. Some questions may overlap, like why do you want to join civil services after doing engineering? You have wasted one seat of engineering or you have wasted one precious seat of IIT, so what will you do now? So these type of questions will come. Most of the time they will come. You are from engineering, why do you want to join civil services? But you have the answer. You have come here thinking of a thing, like thinking of a target. Why do you want to come? What are your competencies? What are your skills which make you more better for a job like civil services than engineering? So you have to justify that. And that will be totally personal. Don't ask from anybody else. Don't go and ask from your friend कि यार बताना कि मैं सिविल सर्विसेज क्यों ज्वाइन करना चाहता हूँ. ये तो तुम जानते हो ना. यू हैव कम फॉर दैट. एंड इफ योर आंसर विल बी जेन्युइन एंड इफ योर आंसर विल बी पर्सनल, बिलीव मी, लाइक यू विल गेट गुड मार्क्स. एंड सो आई विल स्टार्ट नाउ. सो व्हाट चेंज्ड, व्हाट चेंज्ड इन वन ईयर. लाइक इतनी पर्सनैलिटी अच्छी हो गई मेरी कि 150 से 200 पे आ गया. नथिंग चेंज. द थिंग इज, ओनली थिंग चेंज्ड इज माई एटीट्यूड and my approach towards interview. What happens is, when you go for the thing you love the most, you become nervous, and the environment around you creates like increases the nervousness of your mind. अब उस nervous situation में और problem हो जाती है. We start faltering, we start shaking our legs, हमारे हाथ हिलने लग जाते हैं, and there everybody around you is seeing you. इंटरव्यू का पैनल का जो चेयर होता है वो ऐसे होता है, सेमी सर्कल में आप एकदम बीच में बैठते हो, दोनों तरफ से तुम्हें लोग देख सकते हैं. तो ये मत सोचना कि सब लोग, पांचों लोग आगे बैठे हैं और मैं कुछ भी अंदर हिल रहा हूँ उल रहा हूँ, कोई नहीं देख रहा, सब देख रहे हैं. तुम्हारा कॉन्फिडेंस जज हो रहा है. मतलब जैसे कोई हार्ड क्वेश्चन आता है तो इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि यू कैन ऑलवेज टेल आई डोंट नो ऑलवेज. लाइक देयर वाज अ क्वेश्चन इन माय इंटरव्यू कि शुड डेथ पेनल्टी बी डन अवे इन इंडिया. अब देयर आर टू आंसर्स टू दिस, यस और नो, यू हैव टू जस्टिफाई. If you are saying yes, you have to justify why yes. And if you say no, like I said no, it should not be done away with India. It should not be done away in India because the situation is not ripe enough for that. But the thing is, when I came back after the interview, my friends were saying that you have taken a very regressive stand because what we learn, what we write in GS is nahi, death penalty hata do, ye to bahut human rights violations hote hain, reformative justice nahi hota, aise bahut sari cheeze hoti hain. But if you can justify what you are saying, बस इतना चाहिए उनको. दे वॉन्ट योर ओपिनियंस, नॉट ओपिनियंस बिल्ड ऑन योर यू नो न्यूज़ पेपर्स एंड ऑल. यू कैन गेट सर्टेनली हेल्प फ्रॉम न्यूज़ पेपर्स, बट दे वॉन्ट योर ओपिनियंस. सो ओनली थिंग चेंज इज आई स्लेप्ट फॉर 1.5 hours इन दिस, एंड इन दिस आई स्लेप्ट फॉर 9 hours. सो योर एटीट्यूड टुवर्ड्स इंटरव्यू मैटर्स. कि ठीक है, एक इंटरव्यू है, नॉर्मल इंटरव्यू है, आई विल बी माई ओन सेल्फ एंड आई विल गिव द इंटरव्यू वॉट एवर आई नो इन माई ओन स्टाइल. ओके, सो प्रिपरेशन फेज. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल जस्ट गो थ्रू माई प्रेजेंटेशन एंड देन आई कैन टेक इंडिविजुअल क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम यू. दैट वुड बी अ बेटर अप्रोच बिकॉज यू नो इफ आई विल कीप लेक्चरिंग देन यू विल बिकम बोर्ड एंड देन एंड आई हैव नेवर लेक्चर्ड सो आई विल बी अ वेरी बोरिंग टीचर. सो द थिंग इज आई विल जस्ट गो थ्रू हाउ टू स्टार्ट योर प्रिपरेशन. द फर्स्ट थिंग इज detailed application form. So after I think this time they have not made you filled those hobbies interest section before mains, but after the results come or even before the result come, the you have to start thinking about what your hobby is. Like my hobby was designing mechanism in robotics. So you have to end carom playing carom. So you have to choose your hobbies. If you genuinely have a hobby, it's well and good. If you don't have a hobby at all, don't need to write. Okay, like there are many friends of mine who did not write hobbies because they did not have any hobby. I wrote designing mechanism in robotics. I was afraid, should I write it or not? But it was my hobby, so I wrote it. And there were like around 70% of questions were from my hobby in my interview. Like it was based on artificial intelligence. It was based on robotics. It was based on Sophia. Have you heard of Sophia? Yeah. So I'll just ask a random question. Which country did it originate from? Which? Huh? Anybody? Can you tell the continent? Okay. Part of a continent, Southeast Asia, East Asia. It originated in Hong Kong, Hanson Robotics. Saudi Arabia gave the citizenship to Sophia. So this was a question which was asked by a member on the left, and she asked the same question from the next candidate which went in. And he was also an engineer, and she expected an answer. And so the thing is, if you write anything in your DAF, you need to know about it. So like I'm from Bihar, I'm from Sivan, Bihar, and I have done a job in railways. And I have lived in Hyderabad and Lucknow, Delhi and Jamalpur. There is a place called Jamalpur in Bihar. So suppose I have lived in Lucknow and Hyderabad both, and you have also some places on your CV, on your detailed application form, so they can randomly ask what are the common things between Hyderabad and Lucknow, what are the cuisines, what are the, you know, how did Hyderabad got its name, how did Lucknow became a place of you know, city of Nawabs, or why is it like Tehzeeb is associated with Lucknow only and not Kanpur? So these type of questions. So you have to be aware about these things. Your state, everything about your state, what is the demography like, what is the literacy rate, why the literacy rate in your state is very low or very high, or what are the areas in which it can improve, and your school name as well. Suppose I am from City Montessori School, Lucknow. So they asked me a question in interview, what is the meaning of Montessori? Anyone know about what is the meaning of Montessori? Everyone would have heard it. Definitely everybody would know what is Montessori. Like, in their school's name, they would have heard City Montessori School, this Montessori School, that Montessori School. What is the meaning of Montessori? They asked me this question in interview. Anybody know about it? So Montessori, it is a method of education. It was started by Maria Montessori, which thinks that everybody, every child wants to learn something. Very simple meaning. Every child wants to learn something. Everybody knows every child is curious. But they just gave it a name, Montessori. So you should know about it. Suppose somebody's school name may be Rajiv Gandhi Mahavidyalaya. So now Rajiv Gandhi is your responsibility. You have to know everything about Rajiv Gandhi. His policies, scams, or his... Maybe it can go anywhere. Anything. So this is the thing. So this is based on your DAF. So while filling DAF, be very careful. What are the words you write? Every word you write is a potential question. I won Pearl Award in IIT Delhi. I wrote Pearl Award. So I have to know about pearls. What is the city of pearls? How it get, like, what is the process of formation of pearls? So everything you write, just be careful and don't fill it. Like, don't write everything. You are a head boy in school, or you are the most disciplined student in class 9th. I wrote it in my first attempt. So I wrote most disciplined student. What is the criteria for most disciplined? What is discipline? So these are the type of things which, you know, can get you in trouble. Just be very precise. This time I wrote only one things about everything. Like hobbies, I wrote one thing. Interest, I wrote one thing. So these type of things. Second is newspapers. Newspapers is very, very, very important. And read about 2-3 newspapers now. Even if you are not, if you are not giving interview, even if you are not hoping for a result, read 2-3 interview, 2-3 newspapers, because it will give a perspective. The thing is, when we read only one type of newspaper, our ideas, our thoughts, they become lineated. It is not diverse. You have to know about the other parts. So like RCEP, currently there is a meeting going on in Thailand, I think. So in RCEP, everyone is saying that India should not sign it because it's a backdoor entry for China to our Indian market. But there must be some pro, na? There must be some pros, which is at least it's starting a debate. So you should know about its pros as well. And after knowing pros and cons, it is your individual, decision whether you should advise India to go against it or not. So the thing is, just beware about diverse points of views. So read 2-3 newspapers, make notes which are relevant to your DAF as well. So making notes, like, what happens is when we start making notes from newspapers, people start writing so many things that it becomes a book which you can't revise after, when just going before interview or just going before mains. Make precise notes. Just, write only those things which you think that you can remember. Making notes is very easy. You have so many notes here. While going from here to Shankar Road, you will find around 10 terabytes of knowledge. But you can't store it in your mind. So just make only that much notes which you can remember, which you think is important. Write it somewhere. Like I maintained an Evernote. This is an application on computer and your mobile as well. If you find something interesting, you just write it. So I'll just show you a sample of Evernote I have made. This is my Evernote. So there is a feature called tags. So essay, GS1, GS2, GS3, GS4, interview. So interview, I have made notes. एंड देन दिस इज जस्ट अ सैम्पल व्हाट यू कैन यू नो यूज एवर नोट एंड टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर. एंड व्हाइल यू आर गोइंग थ्रू ऑनलाइन सोर्सेज और यू आर गोइंग थ्रू सम न्यूज़पेपर्स विच आर ऑनलाइन, देन यू कैन जस्ट कॉपी एंड पेस्ट एंड हाईलाइट इट लाइक दिस. आई हैव हाईलाइटेड दोज आर द थिंग्स विच आई थिंक आई इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर दिस इज फॉर GS1 आई थिंक एग्रीकल्चर GS3. सो द थिंग इज यू हैव टू मेंटेन सम थिंग्स ऑनलाइन सो दैट यू कैन यू नो इट इज फॉर योर रेडी रेफरेंस. यू ओपन योर मोबाइल, यू आर ट्रेवलिंग समवेयर, यू कैन जस्ट रिवाइज इट. वट आई यूज टू डू वॉज ऑन एवरी सैटरडे संडे आई यूज टू रिवाइज माई एवर नोट because this is the kind of information which you can use directly in your exams, your GS papers, your interview, everywhere. So if you have written suppose your optional is political science, so if your optional is political science, you are going through an article, you found that this is very interesting, you just copy paste it in Evernote and highlight the relevant portions. Don't waste time making notes bahut zyada ki matlab sirf notes hi banate rahe. And DAF, I think I have talked about. And then questions. After getting the interview call, I started making a diary in which I used to write questions relevant to me, which I found later on that we were also provided a question set by Next IAS based on my own DAF. So those questions also you can do, you have to do, because, and then practice. The thing is, I had a friend, Utkarsh, he also got 198. We used to practice together in railways. What we used to do is we used to ask random questions. Be as random as you can. What is Utkarsh? What does Utkarsh stand for you? Suppose your name is Deepak. What is the meaning of Deepak? What are the schemes related to Deepak in India? Deepak means light. So what is like Ujala scheme? What is Atal some light scheme? Kuch hai na? To nahi pension yojana nahi. Lights related. So एक है एक लाइट से भी रिलेटेड स्ट्रीट लाइटिंग SLEP, व्हाट इज SLEP, व्हाट इज द ब्यूरो ऑफ एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी डूइंग. यू कैन ब्रांच आउट ओके बाय योर नेम एज वेल. सपोज योर एंड बी अ लिटिल बिट पॉजिटिव अबाउट थिंग्स यू स्पीक अ लिटिल बिट. सपोज आई एम फ्रॉम सिवान. एनीबडी फ्रॉम बिहार हियर? ओके मेनी पीपल आर फ्रॉम बिहार. सो इफ आई आस्क यू अ क्वेश्चन अबाउट व्हाट इज सिवान फेमस फॉर जस्ट रैंडम. So many people will say it's famous for Shahabuddin, he's a gang leader, he's a MP, anything. But the thing is, you have to look positives. These are the things which people remember. You could say that it's the birthplace of first president of India, Rajendra Prasad. Not many people know it. But Sivan is birthplace of Rajendra Prasad. But colloquially, these times, today's times, it's more famous for Shahabuddin. But you have to search for positives. So suppose someone ask ki do you think the respect for police in UP has declined and people don't have any care for the law institutions of law based on the killing of a SHO last year during a protest. So it was relevant during last time's interview. Similar situations can happen. So you have to look for the positives. This was a one-off incident. It was started by some antisocial elements, which is not the idea of the mob, which is not the idea of the people. But it was just a aberration in practice. So I was asking about friends. I was telling you about friends. When you form a group for preparation of interview, like, it can be as small as 2 people and it can be as large as 4 people. But anything greater than 4 number is just, time pass. Everybody is talking about some random stuff which is not going to come in UPSC. But while having a serious discussion with your friends, suppose your medium of speaking is English. You practice in English, but that's not the only criteria in interview. I used many times Hindi in my interview. I thought that I'll be more comfortable in Hindi. If suppose the member asks questions in Hindi, he is expecting an answer in Hindi. But if you have a good command, if you have a good command of language, then it's better. But it's not the only criteria which gives you 200 marks. My English is not that good, and I falter many times. So that time I can use Hindi. They are not judging you for that. So don't think my English is bad. I am a Hindi medium student, or my English is not that flowery. then I'll not get marks and people will judge me for that. It's nothing like that. There are many people in my academy like who always speak in Hindi on podium as well. So that's not a problem. You can speak in English as well as Hindi. But if you have given English as your medium of interview, try to limit it to English. But you know, quality of English is not a problem. And you can switch to Hindi if you are finding a problem. They will tell कि तुम हिंदी में बोल लो, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है. They will tell. They will understand कि कुछ problem हो रही है. Generally they do. Okay. And do some you know self preparation as well. Stand in front of mirror. The thing is, when we are thinking, when we are speaking in like in our own mind, we think that बहुत अच्छा बोल रहा हूँ मैं. मतलब मैं तो फोड़ दूंगा एकदम. कितना अच्छा बोल रहा हूँ, कितने अच्छे आइडियाज़ आ रहे हैं. लेकिन जब उनको बोलना शुरू करते हैं ना, तो वो आइडियाज़ रुक जाते हैं, कहीं अटक जाते हैं वो. एंड वी आर नॉट एबल टू एक्सप्रेस आवर सेल्व्स. मतलब जो हम सोचते हैं वो हम बोल नहीं पाते. और देयर कम्स द मोस्ट प्रॉब्लम. लाइक द सबसे ज़्यादा प्रॉब्लम वहीं पर होता है. तो बस जैसे मिरर के सामने बैठ के कोई भी क्वेश्चन कि व्हाई डू यू वांट टू जॉइन सिविल सर्विसेज, सो यू आंसर टू योरसेल्फ. That's a very good way to increase your confidence. You are seeing yourself and you are speaking. तो उस वक्त जब तुम देखते हो कि ये पॉइंट छूट गया, ये पॉइंट मैं बोल ही नहीं पाया, यहाँ पर मैं अटक रहा हूँ. और ये मतलब it should not feel like कि तुम रटे हुए हो. Use modulations while you speak. मतलब कहीं पर अगर excitement है तो थोड़ा सा आवाज़ थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा हो, अगर कहीं पर वो है तो कम हो. मतलब एक monotonous होता है तो ऐसा लगता है कि रट क्या है. तो उसके लिए थोड़ी प्रैक्टिस हो जाती है. अगर इफ़ यू स्टार्ट प्रैक्टिसिंग विथ योर फ्रेंड्स एट दैट टाइम, दिस मॉड्यूलेशंस ही कैन पॉइंट इट आउट. सो दिस इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट आई थिंक कि लाइक अपार्ट फ्रॉम मॉक्स, बिकॉज यू विल बी गिविंग हाउ मेनी मॉक्स, लाइक 6-7 एंड दे आर अवेलेबल फॉर वेरी लेस टाइम. सो यू नो विथ फ्रेंड्स बी एज रैंडम एज यू कैन बी. आस्क एनी क्वेश्चंस यू लाइक, डू यू थिंक दैट सिवान the least developed district in Bihar, or what are your strengths, what are your weaknesses. If you think something, suppose I'm asking you a weakness, so many people will advise you that show some strength in form of weaknesses, like I'm so serious at study I forget about my health, I become ill, that's my weakness. Or I am so dedicated to my work that I forget about my family. And these type of things may be advised, but I think matlab there should be some genuine weaknesses, like I don't know how to cook. That's a weakness. That's not a you know strength in disguised of a weakness. So these type of things you can use, and think apart from your studies as well while giving answers. Like these strengths and weaknesses, it can be anything. It need not be, I am very hardworking, I am very dedicated, I am very punctual, and I come at time every time someone calls me, or these type of things. So you can say that I am good at driving, I am good at making food. These are your strengths. So these are the things. And so D-Day, the day of the interview. Anybody knows what is the D stands for in D-Day? Why is it called D-Day? What is it? Can somebody raise their hands and tell me? Anybody knows the context of D-Day? How did it came in exist? Huh? No. It's not decision day. Huh? It came during, this word came into relevance during World War II. Actually, D stands for day. In D-Day, it's like day 1, day 2, day 3. So the day of the happening is like the day of the attack is like D-Day. So these type of things, you know, suppose you used this word in interview, they can ask what is D in D-Day. So everything is relevant. Everything you speak, you have to think before speaking. Not that you start being very conscious about it, but while practicing you can be conscious. कि मतलब मैं कुछ बोल रहा हूँ, आई एम यूजिंग सम फैंसी टर्म्स विच आई डोंट नो एनीथिंग अबाउट. सपोज यू यूज आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस इन योर आंसर. सपोज यू सेड दे आस्क्ड कि हाउ कैन यू इम्प्रूव एग्रीकल्चर प्रोडक्शन इन इंडिया, देन यू स्टार्ट यू नो you know, reading from materials and all, you started speaking ki, sir, we will use artificial intelligence for mapping of seeds and mapping of fertilizers and fertilizers and pesticides, and then it will help in improving the productivity, and this will increase the agriculture production. The next question will be, what is artificial intelligence? Suppose you gave an answer like, you know, using machine to act like humans and using the data and all, they will ask the next question, what is data mining? So the thing is, you have to be very precise about what you speak, and don't, you know, start making stories there and then itself. If you don't know, say I don't know. It's not a problem. They asked me a question, I am from railways, so I have a railway background. So they asked me, do you know any explosive proof coaches which is being being made in India? I was not aware of it. I did not know. I have not heard of it. Although I prepared railways, but I could not get in, you know, this information. So I told, I don't know, sir. In my opinion, there is no explosive proof coaches which are being made in India. So it's not a problem if you say no. If you are genuine, but there are some things which you ought to know. In those questions, you can't tell ki, I don't know. Suppose you are from a Rajiv Gandhi school, then you should know ki, what is Rajiv Gandhi. Or if you are from St. Javier's school, you should know who is St. Javier's, who are Jesuits, and how did he come into India. This type of background information you need to have. So this is, you need to have a good sleep, very good sleep, around 7 to 8 hours. And if someone is like complete his sleep in 5-4 hours, then it's okay. But it should not appear on your face. In 2017, what happened is, I could not sleep in night thinking that what will happen next day. What will happen at the most? Which is not happening from the past days. At the most, kya hoga? So you have to be very, you know, satisfied about your preparation. You can't do anything on your last day. So ekdam soch ke sona ki ab jo hoga dekha jayega, ab to pad liye jo padhna tha. Whatever we needed to do, if you are satisfied with yourself, so for being satisfied, you have to be honest in your preparation towards interview. Like if you have given mains or if you haven't given mains, you should start preparing from right now itself. Everything, you should start thinking about your background. What is your background? Kaun sa graduation kiya hai tumne? Kaun sa college se padhe ho? If I am from IIT Delhi, when was IIT Delhi founded? Which how many you know, departments are there? These type of things. Or is management padhate hain ki nahi Delhi mein is type se? Ya fir what is the QS world ranking of IIT Delhi? What is the full form of QS? So ye jo branching out hoti hai, when you start preparing, jotting down on a diary, then it like when you start jotting down things in your diary, that's the day when your interview started. Like your preparation for interview has been started. So start jotting down. Don't be lazy. Aisa nahi kare, mere ko to aata hai. IIT to matlab mere ko apna naam ka matlab pata hai, to main ab kuch nahi likhunga. If you start jotting down, you'll get ideas. You'll get ideas for the next question. And you have to make questions for yourself. If you are, I'll just randomly ask someone, what are your three strengths? दो स्ट्रेंथ के बाद शायद तीसरे पे किसी को याद ही नहीं आएगा कि मेरा तीसरा स्ट्रेंथ क्या है. ऑनेस्टली अभी अपने में अंदर में आंसर देखने की कोशिश करना तुम लोग कि तीन स्ट्रेंथ्स क्या हैं तुम्हारे. अब हार्ड वर्किंग, पंक्चुअल और टाइमलीनेस को तीनों अलग अलग है, नहीं बोलना, वो एक ही है. तो इसलिए स्टार्ट जॉटिंग डाउन एवरीथिंग. ओके, अबाउट माइंड सेट, आई टोल्ड यू इट्स अ नॉर्मल इंटरव्यू, इट्स टोटली क्रैकेबल, एंड इंटरव्यू इज नॉट द ओनली थिंग विच डिसाइड्स योर फेट. For me it was, but for you it may not, because your GS was there, your mains was there. So just be very practical about it. Just think it is another exam, another interview. पिछले साल के इंटरव्यू से पहले मैंने 8-9 इंटरव्यू दिए थे. मेरे को आज तक किसी इंटरव्यू में कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं हुआ था. IIT में भी जब मेरा प्लेसमेंट हुआ था तो उसमें मैंने 2 इंटरव्यू दिए थे, दोनों में हो गया था. उसके बाद सारे इंटरव्यूज में हो गया था. बट लास्ट टाइम आई फॉल्टर्ड जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस एटीट्यूड इन माई माइंड कि पता नहीं क्या हो जाएगा, कौन से लोग आ जाएंगे, खा जाएंगे मुझे, और मैं तो कुछ कर ही नहीं पाऊंगा जिंदगी में अगर ये नहीं हुआ तो. ऐसा तो कुछ है नहीं. दिस इज नॉट द लास्ट थिंग एंड दिस विल नॉट बी योर फर्स्ट थिंग एज वेल. तो मतलब सी, बींग क्रेजी फॉर UPSC इज वेरी गुड, बट डोंट मेक इट योर लाइफ. बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट इन योर प्रिपरेशन, बट दिस इज नॉट द ओनली थिंग. सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी क्लियर कि कोई बात नहीं, एक इंटरव्यू है, दे के आऊँगा, 25 मिनट में डिसाइड होना है सब कुछ, तो उसके लिए अब जितना प्रिपरेशन करना था आई हैव डन फ्रॉम माई साइड, माई वर्क इज़ ओवर, आई हैव डन माई प्रिपरेशन, बस इतना करना है एंड टाइम से पहले पहुँचना है, उसमें पैनिक नहीं होना है। अगर 9 बजे रिपोर्टिंग टाइम है सो यू शुड बी देयर बाई 8:30 एट मोस्ट, ये नहीं कि 8:50 में जाके वहाँ पे वो CISF वालों से लड़ रहे हैं कि मतलब मेरा कहाँ है, मेरा कहाँ है, ऐसे नहीं होता। यू हैव टू बी ऑन टाइम क्योंकि यू नीड अ पीस ऑफ माइंड बाई आफ्टर रीचिंग देयर। अकॉर्डिंग टू मी दिस इज़ वेरी सब्जेक्टिव, मैनी पीपल लाइक टू रीच ऑन 8:55, मैनी पीपल लाइक टू रीच ऑन 7:30, सो अकॉर्डिंग टू मी एट मोस्ट यू शुड रीच देयर बाई 8:30। ऐसा कुछ इसका काम है नहीं इंटरव्यू प्रिपरेशन में, बट स्टिल आई एम टेलिंग यू बिकॉज इफ़ यू हैपन टू गो देयर बी ऑन टाइम। और उस दिन का न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ना होता है, और ऐसा भी नहीं कि मतलब सारे न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ डाले उस दिन, फिर कुछ याद ही नहीं रहा, उनने पूछ लिया कि 3 हेडलाइन बताओ, उसी में सब ख़त्म हो गया, याद ही नहीं आ रहा है कि 3 हेडलाइन क्या हैं उस दिन के। तो इस टाइप के चीज़ें हैं, और द थिंग्स यू रीड ऑन इंटरनेट कि हाउ मेनी स्टेप्स यू कवर्ड वाइल कमिंग इंटरव्यू रूम, ये सब हॉक्स है, ऐसा कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं पूछा जाता है। और ये शीशा है, इसको गिरा देंगे तो कितने टुकड़े होंगे, ऐसा नहीं होता है, ये सब कहीं और का है, किसी को अपना पर्सनल चीज़ें बतानी होती है कि मैं कितना इंटेलिजेंट हूँ, वो लोग ऐसा लिख देते हैं, ऐसा कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं पूछा जाता है। सो कि मतलब विच कम्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कि दिस क्वेश्चन वॉज आस्क्ड इन UPSC IAS इंटरव्यू। एक तो IAS का इंटरव्यू कुछ होता ही नहीं है, UPSC का इंटरव्यू होता है, IAS तो एक सर्विस है ना। तो इस टाइप का है कि डोंट गेट अफ्रेड, इट विल बी बेस्ड ऑन योर डेफ एंड क्वेश्चंस विल नॉट बी आउट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड। तुमने इतना GS पढ़ लिया है कि तुम्हें सारे क्वेश्चंस के बारे में कुछ ना कुछ मालूम होगा। द थिंग इज हाउ टू एक्सप्रेस योर सेल्फ।